Good afternoon and aloha. You know, it's always coming down here to the food bank distribution center. It makes me realize how incredibly lucky we are in the city and county of Honolulu and state of Hawaii for the Hawaii Food Bank. You know, this is a place of hope. This is a place of nurturing and taking care of people on this island who otherwise would not have food. And they do an incredible job every year, year in and year out. And without them, I don't think government could fill that gap. And so I want to say thank you to Ron Mizutani and his entire crew that are here today for what you do every single day. But because of COVID-19, it's even more critical in terms of the services that the food bank provides. In about 2.5 weeks ago, Peter Ho, the president and CEO of Bank of Hawaii, and Mike Akane, the head of the Community Foundation, called me up and said, "Mayor, we need to do more for the people of Oahu and for all the islands, but for Oahu, because of the huge unemployment rolls that we saw as hotels shut down, as restaurants shut down, and people went on unemployment. And these are folks who had never been unemployed before. These are folks who had a good paying job, spouses both working, children in school, never had to come to the food bank or anywhere for food assistance. And now they have no job. And with the backlog in unemployment claims, without getting the PPP money from the federal government, they were going hungry. And at times they didn't know where to go because they had never had to go anywhere for food before. And how do we meet this short-term need for this gap group of people? And we needed to act quickly. And so I'm really proud of the fact that working with the food bank, working with the Community Foundation and the Resilience Fund, they stepped up and said, we will make a difference. We will commit $1 million to the food bank to help get food to people who really need it, who didn't need it in the old days. And the city and county of Honolulu stepped up and said, we'll contribute $1 million too. So the Resilience Fund of the Community Foundation and the city and county of Honolulu will each put in $1 million for a total of $2 million. And what that means is 256,000 people will be fed in the next 8 weeks in sites around this island who otherwise wouldn't get the food they need. This time of this pandemic, it's so reaffirming to see people stepping up and trying to help those who really need the help. You know, and what's, I love the fact that our Royal Hawaiian Band, who plays over 350 concerts a year, who right now is not playing any concerts, are helping in the packaging, transportation, and delivery and handing out of this food. You know, a band that was created by Kamehameha III, the oldest municipal band in the country, is doing their part too. Instead of playing music, the voice of Kamehameha is still spoken through the actions as they hand out food to people who otherwise would not get the food they need. We're going to help in other ways. The city is going to provide venues. We're going to provide sites, and those sites include Kaka'ako Waterfront Park, Kaka'ako Beach Park on the North Shore, Waimanalo Recreation Center, the Waipio Peninsula Soccer Complex. And the first handout is going to be, or feeding is going to be, April 30th at Waipio Peninsula Soccer Complex from noon to 4 p.m. And the city, besides the venues, will get permits. HPD will be there to provide traffic control. There will be additional traffic support, like electronic signage. And then, of course, we'll have our city volunteers like Royal Hawaiian Band. And Clark Bright, the bandmaster, is here. Again, though, we could not have done this. We could not have done this without the food bank saying, we will be that hub in getting this food distributed. And it's looking at, you know, the food partners like Cisco Hawaii, Hawaii Food Service Alliance, the Hawaii Ranchers, and the Hawaii Farm Bureau. I think particularly ranchers and farmers who provided a lot of food to hotels and restaurants who do not have that opportunity now can feed people in desperate need of food. And the community partners, the 2020 Census Bureau, the Child and Family Services, and the Domestic Violence Action Center, these people are helping too. And we just want to thank everyone so much. With that, I like the man of the hour, Ron Mizutani, for all he does. We're lucky he left one job for, I believe, a better job, and he's doing an excellent, incredible, outstanding job to walk us through the next parts of what we're going to be doing. Thank you so much. Mahalo and aloha.
Thanks.
Sorry about the beeping, but it is a warehouse, and we're in operations right now. But very humbled, Mayor, to be a part of this effort. And when you folks reached out, I got a phone call from Pam Friday afternoon about 5:30. Ron, can we make this happen? I said, you bet. Then I panicked. Truthfully, inventory is low. I mean, just look around. You can see the needs are so significant in Hawaii right now. In Oahu, we instantly saw a spike of 30% in food. That's grown to more than 60%. That has impacted inventory in a very great way, but I said, we're gonna make it happen. We're gonna make it happen because we have good partners. And I look at Mike Akane, I look at you, Momi, and I say, mahalo nui, for opening your hearts and saying, what can we do to help? $2 million goes a long way when it comes to feeding. But the amount of mouths and the amount of families and the amount of people impacted by COVID-19 has been significant. And as we see unemployment numbers skyrocket to numbers we never could even imagine, we know that this need will be very much fulfilled and needed. But we can't do it without partners. We can't do it without money. We can't do it without food. So I made a phone call to Chad Buck from HFA, Cisco, Hawaii, Jason Wong, who happens to be on our board. And I called Brian Miyamoto and I said, guys, I need your help. What can we do? How can we feed 250,000 people in the next 4 to 6 weeks and even maybe extend it out to 8 weeks? They said, what do we need to do? We'll make it happen. So I thank you. I thank you, Chad. I thank you, Jason, Brian. We've had a new partnership with the Hawaii Farm Bureau, and it's really showing the need for sustainability in Hawaii. We learned some valuable lessons with COVID-19 on how ill-prepared we are as a state, but that's another conversation that we'll revisit when this is all pow. And then I said, Chad, I need ranchers. I need beef. What can we do? Not a problem. I'll call the ranchers on every island, and we'll start slaughtering to get food here in time. So Chad, mahalo for that as well. We wanted to expand this beyond just food, though, because as we all know, COVID-19 is really having an impact on our families, on our hearts, on our patient level. Lord knows we've all been maxed up. So we called our friends over at Child Family Service and Karen Tan. We called the Domestic Violence Action Center, my dear friend Nancy Creedman, for many years, and it said, I'd like you to be a part of this. This is very important that we let families know that there's help for you even with this. COVID-19 has really impacted families in a great way. Then we had the Census Bureau on my mind. I've had that on my mind because I want numbers to be accurate as we move forward. Not a big fan of Census Bureau numbers because I think they're flawed. But again, that's for another story. But this is our opportunity to get people to understand the value of the 2020 census. So we called Robbie and said, Robbie, can you be a part of this? And Robbie said, yes, we'll have all the material you need ready for these distributions. It's an ambitious project that we're taking on. Every dime contributed by the city and county of Honolulu, Bank of Hawaii Foundation, Mike Akane and HCF, every dime of it will go into food. Nothing with operations with food bank. Every single penny. And my staff probably said, what? We'll continue to serve the 1 in 8 that we already serve and the bigger audience that we continue to serve right now. But for this effort, we wanted to fill the gaps that Mayor talked about. And there are many gaps. We have a very robust infrastructure with Hawaii Food Bank, over 200 partner agencies that currently have feedings, distributions, whether it be soup pantries right now. At this moment, as we speak, we have a massive distribution happening at Windward Mall. I think about 500, 600 cars are going to be serviced there. I'm getting the thumbs up from Laura K. Rand. Tomorrow, White and I, Mall, we're going to have a massive distribution as well. So we are serving now, and there will be opportunities that exist right now beyond this coming initiative. I can just show you real quick, and I want to make sure that we continue to serve everybody. So if you don't mind stepping forward. But this is kind of a map of what we have in place that it currently exists. And we'll have this available on our website at hawaiifoodbank.org. We'll also supply it to the media so that you can have it on your websites, and we'll give it to the city as well so that it's handy. The reason why we thought it was important to make sure that folks know is when we all meet Thursday, it will take an army to do what we haven't planned. And our goal is obviously to feed all, to have access for all. That's been our motto. But we're going to try the best to do what we got. But people will not walk away empty-handed. These exist right now. And there'll be a super kitchens, food pantries, our Ohana Produce, which is where we get a lot of food out the door. Our food for keiki and our food for our kupuna. This is where you can go on island and see an area or community near you where you can get help today and even after this event is Pau, and even after COVID leaves the islands. I don't want to say any more because I want Momi to share some words, but I just want to say one more thing. And I'll try not to get emotional. Sorry. I love my staff. All of you on the front line. And putting yourselves as well and your families and everybody on the front line out there. We will be stronger when this is all done. As an island and as a state. And as individuals. So, Mayor, thank you for your heart. Momi, mahalo, Micah, I love you. And to all my brothers out there, we got some work to do. I look forward to standing by your side and serving. Hawaii Food Bank will be there, as it has been long before I arrived and long after I will leave. 35 years in existence, Hawaii Food Bank has been there. So thank you very much. And Momi, if you don't mind saying a few words. Sorry.
Thank you, Ron. Hello, everyone. You know, I think what this has all really shown that this is all about community coming together. So thank you, City and County of Honolulu, Mayor Kirk Caldwell, Ron and his incredible staff and volunteers, and all of the partners joining us today. Bank of Hawaii Foundation is also committed to helping our families to provide relief for those that are affected by COVID-19. We have donated $3 million to the Hawaii Community Foundation and the Hawaii Resilience Fund to help address the societal and economic impacts that's, you know, happening now because of this pandemic. We have allocated $1 million towards food relief to assist residents on Oahu and our neighbor islands, with $750,000 donated towards this effort. Our hope is that we can help relieve some of the stress that we know that so many are feeling right now. Together, we will be stronger. We encourage others to help donate because our dollars can go further. Bank of Hawaii remains committed to helping our families to stay nourished, to stay healthy, and to be fed. Thank you so much to everyone. Mahalo.
I just wanted to mention two other groups. One, Pam Woody Oakland, who's our director of community services, who's out there housing people every day and really during the pandemic, making sure people stay in their homes, helped work on this and got it together with other partners discussed. And I just want to say thank you, Pam Woody Oakland, for all you've done. And then, you know, we're going to do a smaller handout of food feeding to people in the hotel industry. You know, people have been laid off, and that's going to happen this Sunday. And we have Mike Yamaguchi of LW Local 142 here, and then Local 5. So they will be getting food out to the folks they know need food. And these same folks are the ones who are helping at Ka'ahi with a homeless population and cleaning rooms and taking care of people that are quarantined while their test comes back that don't have homes. You know, people who don't have jobs are taking care of people who don't have homes. People who don't have jobs are taking care of their fellow workers who can't eat. And again, it tells us who we are as a people. You know, Ron, you got choked up. You got me choked up. But it's a reaffirming thing about the uniqueness of the people of Hawaii coming together in times like this. So I want to thank you. And if there's questions, you can ask them all of Ron Yuzutani. Okay, Ron?
I'll take notes of any questions. Yeah, ready. No city questions, no questions.
So Brandy has to show up if she has a question, show up.
Yeah, my meter friends go easy on me. I just, you know, we're trying our best to honor social distancing in these efforts. And we do that here. Our warehouse is like we've never seen it. Not that it's never been clean. This is like Costco, but only better. But we've had a staff that really paid attention to making sure that our areas are clean. You may see signage everywhere reminding not only those who come here to gather food, but more importantly so that we can protect our own team and our own family. Everybody's equipped with an N95. Where's Tom Louis? Tom's back there somewhere. He had the vision to order N95s long before anybody did. And he said, can I pull a trigger on it? This was long before we had our first positive. That's the kind of minds we have here working at the food bank, always thinking ahead. I see my dear friend Kim there. She handles all of her agencies. She probably just came from Windward Mall. Without our partner agencies distributing the food, it would be quite a challenge. But any questions?
Yes, Ron. Yeah. So this first question is from Casey Harlow at Hawaii Public Radio. You mentioned the food bank saw a 30% increase in need instantly in the initial days of the COVID-19 pandemic. In your last conversation with Casey, you said that number was going to change. Has the demand increased since the end of March, and by how much?
So looking into April, yes. Casey, thank you for the question, and we appreciate our dear friends at HBR and the relationships we have there. The key thing with that relationship with HBR and other media outlets is getting timely information out and accurate information. Our numbers are very real. We know that by what amount of food goes out the door. We instantly saw an increase in needs, close to 30% in a matter of 2 days. And then before that, and then by the end of the week, we saw it spiked over 30%. And since Casey and I spoke, it is over 60%. And if you go, we measure that from year. You know, and I think about not only the food inventory needs, but to give a better idea of that is often to look at finances, because finances carry the day with the food and supply. We normally spend $33,000 a month during the spring months to purchase food. But because donations are just not coming in, and we understand that, that has increased to a whopping $700,000 in 1 month. That's real. Our annual budget is $400,000. Thankfully, to the grace of our community and our very giving community, we've been able to match supply and demand. What May will look like, we don't know. This effort will help soften that, I'm confident. So the $2 million that we have promised to us, the food bank, again, all of that's going right back into food, right back into the families in need. That'll soften, hopefully, some of the spikes that we see and our distribution points, which will not change. So long answer to that question, it'll probably stay the same. I'm hopeful that the city's efforts and these distributions for the next few weeks will help alleviate some of that pressure on our team and also our inventory load. The reality is there's the food inventory in Hawaii is very fragile. And thankfully we have partners with the Farm Bureau. We're buying ranchers' meat, we're buying fish, keeping our farmers farming. We're part of the sustainability conversation. And we need to do that post-COVID as well.
When it comes to the distribution, can one car pick up more than one food box?
Actually, that's what we're encouraging. And we are, I won't say requiring, because we all know that not everybody can do so, but we're really encouraging folks to, if you can come and represent 2 to 3 families, we'll be asking you some questions, not only to gather data for us, but also we want to understand who's out there coming, if you've lost a job. It's nothing invasive questioning, but if we can have 2 to 3 cars come per 2 to 3 families per vehicle, you'll get that amount of food per family, but it'll soften the line flow and keep the traffic flowing. Just to visualize what potentially could be miles of traffic. And that's one way to take care of it.
Another follow-up from Casey Harlow. Do you have an estimate of how much money the food bank has spent so far to meet the increased need? And how much do you expect to spend in the next month?
That's a good question, Casey. I'm looking at my finance people. It's probably north of one point. For the amount of money we've committed to, this is not part of this project. Mm-hmm. This is separate. I would say close to 1.3. Closer to $1.5 million in food purchases. Remember, now we have a budget of $400,000. Nobody can prepare for this.
And has the food bank received any funding from the CARES Act?
We've contemplated applying for it, but right now we're focusing on our mission, and so we have not received anything from the CARES Act. Questions for the mayor? If you folks have any other questions, call me direct. You guys know my line. and I can do what I can. But again, I just want to say before you guys hang up, Mayor, thank you again. Micah, Kane, Momi, Mahalo, and especially to our food partners, Brian, Mr. Chad, and your wife, Steph. You guys are so giving. Oh, and Jason, I think we have one more question.
And Ron, if you could just go over again where the pickups will be and when.
Okay, we're still establishing our timeline and schedule. We have the venues, thank you to the city. By the way, have been great partners during this COVID experience. We've had to adjust some of our distribution points, and the City Parks Department have worked with us to find solutions. So in this effort, though, we'll have four distribution sites that we've all agreed on. Kaiaka in Haleiwa, Waimanalo Rec Center. Our first distribution will be at YPO Soccer Complex. And then also the one other one is in Kaka'ako. That was strategically done to hit communities island-wide. We'll have a more determined schedule. It'll be Wednesdays and Fridays from 12 to 4. We do that because we want to manage inventory the best we can. We can't do that without food. So we'll get schedules up on our website, and I certainly will be talking with Pam and Mayor and all of you as well so that people are aware of these existing. But again, go to hawaiifoodbank.org and see opportunities of food distributions in your area that's more convenient as well. So this is just one other added element of the many different projects going on at one time. I just want to also say one more thing. There's a lot of people doing good work, great work, whether it be for Kupuna, whether it be hot meals being prepared, some of our own friends involved. And I want to say mahalo to them as well, because this is really taking a whole community effort. So, mahalo.